Yeah. Baby girl, you're so damn fine, no. Wanna know if I can hit it from behind, dog. I'm sipping on you like some fine wine, dog. When it's over, I press rewind, dog. Talking back.
Released on the 12th of September 2013, Arma 3 is a massive military sandbox game aiming to simulate warfare in great detail with a wide variety of single and multiplayer content. Arma 3 is the PC player's go-to military simulator with over 20 vehicles and 40 weapons authentically created to give the player a unique and immersive experience. Now, let's get a bit of background with the Arma series before we start. So let's go from the beginning. The first game in the Arma series released by Bohemia Interactive was Arma, Armed Assault. This was released in 2006 and was the first time Bohemia Interactive attempted a go at the first and third person military simulation gameplay. Next, Arma 2 was released in 2009. This made a massive step up from the first game, both graphically and mechanically, introducing new gameplay features, modes, and later on a whole variety of modders came together to make a plethora of mods, changing graphics, sounds, maps, and whole new time eras. The most famous being DayZ, which spanned into a standalone game and other mod creators attempt to copy and paste it into later games. After this, Bohemia Interactive had a lot to live up to with their next Arma game, and so was released Arma 3. The two main maps in Arma 3 are Altis. Clocking in at 270 kilometers squared, Altis is a Greek island famous for its rolling hills and expansive terrain. From wind farms to solar farms, islands to cities, Altis lends itself to massive multiplayer warfare and complements the mechanics of the simulation. The second map is Stratis, at a smaller 20 km square battlefield which is advantageous to close quarters operations or infiltration missions. With its rugged terrain, it's perfect for infantry engagements and combat in the air alike. Other maps and terrains have been added in by the extensive modding community, such as Takistan from the Arma 2 Operation Arrowhead expansion, and the biggest Arma 3 map yet, Australia. As of yet, the Arma 3 development team have released a trailer for an up and coming map, Tanoa. Set on the South Pacific island, this map will change the way Arma 3 combat is played out, and players will have to adapt to the densely forested areas and terrain. Multiplayer is the preferred way to play by many players, as there is a huge variety of mods and game modes to try. Some of the popular game modes include Wasteland. Survive in a desolate island, scavenge for resources and weapons, build bases, team up with other survivors and wage war against hostile clans. Breaking Point. A modded version of the DayZ mod from Arma 2, it's survival of the fittest against zombies and players alike. Battle Royale. Pitted in a fight to the death, players have to use their skill and wits to win the Hunger Games styled event. Who will be the last man standing? Life mods. Ranging from the non-modded Altis Life game mode to the extensively thought out and intricately designed City and Takistan Life. This life mode gives the players a chance to roleplay in the massive open world map. Will you farm? Work in the police station or in the anti-terrorist armed forces, or will you choose the path of robbing banks, smuggling drugs across the border, or join the terrorist groups aiming to take down the economy? These are just some of the extensive mods and game modes in Arma 3 multiplayer. They give the player so much to choose from and keeping you entertained for hours on end. As we have talked about the multiplayer element, we are going to move on to the single player version of Arma 3. Boasting a highly detailed and realistic campaign, Arma 3 single player will take you into the depths of the military, teaching you real life tactics and weaponry. The campaign takes you into Altis, the Greek island torched by civil war, and you are in the NATO peacekeeping force to try and settle the matters. Alongside the campaign, there are a variety of boot camp and training scenarios you can try to get to grips with the mechanics, such as ordering troops, flying helicopters and jets, and even scuba diving with the bomb disposal unit. Although Bohemia Interactive have put countless hours into creating an in-depth single-player experience for Arma 3, in my opinion, the community-made scenarios and single-player mods are what make it shine. From zombie apocalypses, to surviving a world coming to an end, dodging meteor strikes and tsunamis, to infiltrating enemy bases under the cover of darkness to retrieve some much-needed intel, and even playing as a futuristic soldier attacking an enemy stronghold in mech suits. The scenarios are endless. Introduced in Arma 2, but carried on into Arma 3, is the in-depth editing mode. Here, you can make different scenarios, and you can play with you on your own or with friends. Create missions you can overcome, or full out new parts of a map. Recently released is the new Eden editor, which gives the players a realistic 3D editor, expanding the opportunities. So, is this game worth your money? Coming in at £35.99 or $50, Arma 3 is not a budget title, although with this you will get hundreds if not thousands of hours of immersive gameplay and stunning visuals to make you get your money's worth. Arma 3 is often on sale, you can sometimes get it as low down to $20 if you catch it at the right time, so it's definitely following it if you're not prepared to buy it just yet. What are your thoughts on the game? Is it worth the money? Leave a comment down below and give any suggestions on games you would like me to cover next. But until then, thank you guys for watching. Remember to subscribe to the channel for more content. And if this was a helpful video, remember to like and share it. Also, don't forget to check out my Facebook and Twitter to stay up to date with everything I post. But for now, it's goodbye from me. Down screaming.